Hello there, good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Our mining specialist here at Proactive, Ryan Long, is joining us once again today to discuss IronRidge, because there's been so much going on and a lot of excitement surrounding this spin out of their gold assets. What detail can you give us, Ryan?
Well, to be honest with you, Katie, not a huge amount. It's still early days and IronRidge hasn't released a huge amount of information yet. What we do know is that both the assets in Côte d'Ivoire and the Chadian gold projects are going to be spun out into a new gold-focused business, and that's going to be listed on a recognised stock exchange. We don't know which exchange yet. It's also likely that that company is going to have its own board and management team. Again, we don't know what that board and management team are like at this stage. I guess there's two principal ways really that IronRidge can do this spin out and ensure value is retained for shareholders. One could be that IronRidge itself retains an interest in the new NewGoldCo. The other would be an in-species dividends to shareholders of IronRidge or of the new shares in NewGoldCo, in the new NewGoldCo. The exact timing of this spin out, again, it's completely uncertain at this stage, but based on our experience, we'd expect it to be post-August, probably also before the end of the year, just based on typical timelines to complete the documentation, appoint the necessary advisors, and potentially raise any funds needed by the new NewGoldCo. Mm-hmm. Of course, all that's subject to market dynamics and may well change, but I hope that gives a bit of a broad idea of when this transaction could happen.
Yeah, so maybe third or fourth quarter, potentially. It'd be really interesting to find out what course they choose to go on. In regards to the key benefits for shareholders then, what would you say they were, Ryan?
I guess the most important thing for any investor is to reassure them that they're going to maintain their exposure to all the projects, and they're going to benefit from any uplift in value at each of those projects as they're advanced. Both IronRidge's lithium and their gold projects are currently undervalued in the merged state. So by demerging them, both projects should see an uplift in value as a result. By having two companies, each focused on one specific commodity, the businesses are going to be much more attractive to certain type of investors who only like to invest in single commodity businesses. And also, as single commodity businesses, they should benefit more from any uplift in each commodity price, be it lithium or gold. Also, having a corporate structure where each management team has its own focus, its own balance sheet, and can ensure they advance each asset in the most appropriate way to deliver value for shareholders is going to be a big benefit for the shareholders in IronRidge. And it's also going to make it cleaner and easier and a more simple process to secure strategic funding for the development of each project, be that through a joint venture or any other kind of corporate transaction.
So we will be expecting news galore, I would imagine. What can you outline maybe what we should be expecting in the next maybe 6 to 24 months, do you think?
Well, focusing on it, we've still got the tail end of the drill program results to come in. IronRidge have drilled around 16,600 metres, and they've only reported 12,000 metres of that so far. So we're going to have all those assay results come in probably early Q3. Mm-hmm. All the drilling that they've done is likely to result in an updated mineral resource estimate. And I think timing for that's probably going to be early Q4. Now, what's interesting is that resource estimate, if there's a big upgrade in it, it potentially can extend the life of Ewoyaa. Currently, the scoping study was talking about 8 years. That could well go to 10 years or beyond. So I'd expect IronRidge to release an updated scoping study that takes into account the potential extension to mine life, any change in grade, the deposit, as well as the increase in the spodumene concentrate price we've seen recently. And that's likely to be a Q4 event this year. Alongside that, IronRidge have talked about kicking off their pre-feasibility study. That's probably going to happen in Q3 this year. And then completion of that pre-feasibility study, that's likely to be a H2 next year event. So there is plenty going on for shareholders at the moment.
It certainly sounds like that. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you for sort of outlining the timeline for us there and maybe demystifying some of what's going on for shareholders. It certainly sounds exciting and busy and lots to come, I would imagine. Brian Long, thank you so much indeed on IronRidge this morning, talking about the spin out of their gold assets and giving us a bit of detail on the bones. Thank you for your time.
Pleasure, Katie. Thank you.